All right, I have a transmission out of a 1991 Ford Explorer. This is called an A4LD, and this actually is a core that I had to purchase. I work actually with an exporter who sends out who exports auto parts, transmissions, transfer cases, converters, even cars, you know, all over the world. So he had called me up and told me he had a 1991 Ford Explorer that needed a transmission. So he said, I need you to get a core, overhaul it, and ship it over to him, and he's gonna ship it out overseas somewhere. So we finally located one, and we're gonna open this up. May not find too much wrong with it, because they actually, the yard that I bought it from actually had to take it out of the car. So we're gonna open it up and see what we find. I gotta just do a regular overhaul. And I guess that's about it. So I'll get a little closer and we'll kind of just tear this thing down. And again, not sure if we're gonna find anything, but we still gotta tear it down and do the overhaul. All right, so this one snap ring came out of here. Now that servo. Now let's get this one. Okay. Not sure how easy these are gonna come out. Very easy. The spring on this is much, on second gear here is much heavier. And this spring you're gonna see is lighter. So this might actually might have to knock this out from the inside. Okay, so usually to identify the correct piston on these covers, there is two letters. This one here says B, B, boy, boy. That's how you usually identify which piston you need. And this one here, I might have to, again, knock this out from the inside. This one here says, looks like it says AA. No, this says AB. Okay. All right, so we'll get that one out later. Your modulator goes here. Let me just show you the, this is the modulator valve here, and this is the pin, and you don't want to lose the pin. I don't really have the modulator, it just kind of came with, actually was broken off. Let me show it to you. You know, this is supposed to be together. Actually, let me just knock this thing together, and I'll show you. It actually was a part, but that's the modulator there. And the pin, of course, goes in here. All right, so I'm gonna pull this bell housing off. Actually, what I'm gonna do first is loosen the two band adjustments. All right, where is my 3/4? It's not there. Here it is. Your kick down here, and this is your neutral switch. Neutral switch, I mean, it might be good, but when we do these particular jobs for this guy, everything is new. All right, so I'm gonna just pull this bell housing over here. Thank you.
And I'll open this up.
This, you know, is the pump. What we do is we send the case halves out, the three main pieces, the bell housing, the main case, and the tail, and we have it all done up nice, sandblasted, so we can give it a nice paint job. Band out. Okay. Now, like I said, you know, it's probably not in that bad shape, but two van struts. Here's the overdrive. Spring in here I'm going to change. There in here. Something just fell. There's the rig for the bearing fell. That, another bearing here. Taking this strut, main strut out, but it just dropped. Alright, so I'm not gonna get that. Alright, next thing we're gonna do is get the snap ring out, and then we'll flip it and take the pan off. This actually is governor. This works, shifts on the governor. There is no input sensor. Let me just get set up for that. They have a basket. And here's all the parking stuff. Park all spring around. Here we go, Governor. That's nice and free. Make sure we can take that out now. Show what this thing looks like real quick. All right, here's the housing. Here's the valve. There's a spring in here, little spring and the counterweight. Little spring, and here is the counterweight here. So we drop the valve in. Drop the spring. That's it right there. Now, let's go back to take the pan down. Then, of course, from this, they merged into the 4R 44 55E, and then the 5R 55E, and the 5R 55S. Alright, of course, pan is clean. Okay. We have a four-wheel drive filter. Got a couple of O-rings here on the filter. Right now we got two solenoids. One solenoid, I believe it's this one, is lockup, and one is like the overdrive cancel, or 3-4 solenoid. It's been a while since I did one of these. Alright, now I'm going to take this cover off. There may be a large spring behind this cover. There's a piston for the reverse band. Yeah, this spring normally gets left out. I'll just put it back. Let me just go turn that light on. Then we're going to take the valve body off. All right, let's get this valve body off. All right, I'm going to unplug the, pull the wires off of the solenoids. That connector will stay on the case. get a needle nose plier here.
Pull this wire up. Okay, there we go. And here's the bracket that holds the solenoid bracket, you know, that holds the solenoid down, that doesn't fall out. All right, so this will come right up. One more. Okay, this should come right out. Go. And here's the valve body. Okay, now they have this spring in here, I just noticed it. This is kind of like a restrictor, you know, a lot of times this thing gets left out by accident, really not a big deal, goes right here. Let's see if that is the 30. For the center support. Little bolt there for the center support. The nut is on the inside. All right, let's see if we can slide this out. Here is the other half that that sense support bolt goes to. And these rings here are rubber rings. I don't see any washer here. This will be a snap shell. This here is a snap shell. So you see it's held on here, and there is no washer here. All right, if this was not a snap shell, there would be a washer here. All right, so this we gotta kind of just snap. We'll get to them in a moment. Governor sits on, and you know when you get this thing back together, like you get the valve body on, and the governor's not on yet, you blow through the holes, you hear the shift valve move. Okay. Big washer here, sits there, actually sits in the case there. Need a little band drum. These things do tend to break, so I am going to change that. I've seen that before. All right, so this case is stripped. Spring is much lighter for the overdrive. That's for a second. Here's the two here. Okay. All right, so just get rid of this oil. We'll open up the pump. We'll take a look at the, we'll unsnap the shell, take a look at the clutches, and that's really about it. And I'll start cleaning it up, and then we got to get the cases all done up nice, sandblasted nice, as we paint it, get the converter done. All right, just give me a few minutes. Okay, so again, here's our setup here. We got to unsnap these shells. We got one, two, I guess two. All right, so what we do here, we need a couple of screwdrivers. Alright, I want to get a screwdriver in here. I want to pry up on this. Get a screwdriver in here like that. Here. Got a here. Sorry, bearing in here. Another bearing here that sits on top. All in direct drum. We have, instead of, again, the washer is here when you don't have a snap shell. So now we have this bearing that's going to sit here instead of the washer. Okay. Yeah, again, clutches look good. Still see the writing on them. I do have a banner kit for this though. And this piece here, inside the forward clutch drum, this rubber, this sits against the clutch, you know, the clutch pack, and cushions it. This comes new in the old roll kit. Clutches. Again, really not finding much wrong with this. These clutches actually look pretty good. Get set up for that. Give me 1 second. And I gotta readjust the camera. Alright, so real quick, I used my my impact driver here to get these loose. So these all are loose now. Come right out. Front seal, and you can see that front seal there, it has that gray. So that seal actually is no good, so we gotta make sure we put the good seal back, especially because this thing is going overseas. Okay, pump plate and your gears. These gears out. Okay, this has a dot, faces down. And this one. This one can only go one way. And this does not have the O-ring that your later ones have in it for the lockup. This is the pump here, looks good. I'm gonna change this O-ring. Not O-ring, it's a solid Teflon ring for lockup. I'm going to change this, and I'm going to change the bushing in here as well. Alright, so I think that's about it. This is the overdrive drum here. You know, these clutches, there's just a couple of them in there. I mean, you know those are good, but we do have a banner kit coming this morning. And that's about it. 1991 Ford Explorer. This is an A4LD, governor shifted transmission. And then here's this for the kickdown here. And I got to clean all this up, overhaul it. These I like to do along with the 4R55, 4R44Es, put shift kits in. I think they work very nicely with shift kits. So I'm going to be doing that as well. And I guess that's about it. So I got to get this thing going. And get it over to the guy. We actually set it up nice on a pallet, and we anchor it down. It gets, you know, we sandblast it so it gets painted, because that's how this guy is. He's very, very particular. And if he likes what he sees, he'll keep coming back. So we've been doing business with this guy for quite some time. And we've done, you know, we've gotten standard transmissions shipped overseas that we've done, automatics. He had sent us, he deals with also exotic cars, very rare cars, and you know, in the 40s and 50s, and there was
a car called a dual Ghia that he had, you know, we said, I can't find a transmission, we need that one. So he arranged to have that one brought to us. We did it, sent it back. So we did a lot for this guy. All right, so I guess that's about it. I thank you guys for watching. Have a great day. We'll see you next one.